Hello everyone, this is Dr. Anam Zaheer and I'm back with my fifth book review, which is about the textbook of homeopathic therapeutics in ophthalmology by Dr. Rohit Deshpande. So after his first book, which was about clinical comparative materia medica, comparing across the system, in which the book compared 333 medicines, and with the help of his keen observation and deep clinical understanding, Dr. Rohit Deshpande was came up with the concept of this therapeutic book. So today I'll be giving review of this book. If you have not yet subscribed our YouTube channel, don't forget to hit the bell icon and follow us for learning more and more about homeopathy on our Instagram account homeopathy.heals. So let's get started. As you can see, the energy, the aura of book is so lovely. It is a hardbound book and white in color. It has total 284 pages and published by Deshpande Publication. This book is easily available on both Amazon and in Kindle edition. Now I'll be telling you about the content of the book. This book has four parts: index, introduction, the therapeutic section, and afterwards. In index, we have all the clinical conditions listed and they are all arranged in alphabetical manner. Like as you can see, I have opened index for you. Yeah, here comes the index. As you can see, all the clinical conditions, they are aligned in an alphabetic manner, from amaurosis to last weakness of vision. Next comes the introduction part. In introduction part, I mean, I feel like personally it's the most favorite part of the book, because Boss has written, what do you mean by therapeutics? We all know there are so many ways of studying homeopathic materia medica and practicing it too. Some they practice over or give emphasis over mentals, like Dr. J.T. Kent or M. Kent. Okay, so some they study over the pathophysiological action, like Blackwood materia medica, some over clinical condition. So this is also a way in which materia medica can be studied, which is therapeutic. The mystery is solved how to study materia medica, because the list of all prominent indicated remedy is given after each disease condition. These only those remedies are given which are clinically and thoroughly verified by the author, and there is a combination of sphere of action and pathophysiological action which made it become more authentic and very much easy to prescribe. So author has beautifully given that the totality of symptoms, they are of prime importance, not only mind and physicals, but the sphere of action and pathophysiological action. With the every clinical condition, he has given 10 top remedies which are verified by himself, and in the initial pages of book he has made clear that the dosage, the potency, the repetition, all and all solely depend upon the susceptibility of the patient. That's why the dosages or potency is not mentioned in this book. Next comes the therapeutic section, and various clinical conditions, as I've told you, are mentioned in the therapeutic section. There are sign and symptoms and the 10 homeopathic top 10 remedies. I'll give an example. If you see on page number 76 of this book, so topic dryness of eye is given. So a small definition of dryness of eye is given, that it's a very common ailment when eyes do not produce tear. So it cannot eliminate dust, therefore there is irritation. Then few common symptoms are given, like stinging, burning pain, redness, blurness of vision, and top 10 remedies like arsenic, album, pulsatilla, sulfur, etc. It is given. So that's how remedy is given in across the clinical condition. Later, the important clinical indication of each drug is also given. Like arsenic album, it is aggravated by artificial light. Pulsatilla, aggravated by in morning and in warm room. In sulfur, it is aggravated by night and after lacrimation. And in alumina, it is aggravated by evening. Now comes the scope of the book. Apart from a user-friendly, this book is oriented for not only for third year students, say okay, I buy it and I pass out my therapeutic exam, but it is a very useful for day to day homeopathic practitioners as well. Okay, it has opened up all the ways that even in ophthalmic cases homeopathy can do excellent. It has covered all the psoriatic complaints like conjunctivitis, iritis, to syphilitic complaints like retinal detachment and hemorrhage of the eye. Clinical condition after each drug made it very useful for the practical purpose. There is easy differentiation and selection of remedies. Even modalities of drugs, it is beautifully depicted after each drug. Now, if there's a scope, there's a limitation. But honestly, I don't find any shortcoming of this book as of now. At last, the final part afterward is given, where author has given his phone number, email ID, website for easy communication. So my dear peers, homeopaths, so it's a must-have therapeutic book in our library, and it is going to enhance our knowledge to explore more and more about ophthalmic therapeutics. Thank you so much. I hope you have liked this review, and definitely if you buy this book after watching this review, do tag me on Instagram @homeopathy.heals. Till then, stay fit, stay healthy. Homeopathy Heals.